Monday morning about 11. I'm bound to Restaurant Depot, pick up a few knives I need. I just picked up a new restaurant rental account, and they've got 11 knives that I got to pick up in a little while and exchange. Well, I'm short one fish fillet knife and one, serrated knife, so I got to pick up two knives. Then I'll take them home and check them out. Then I'll take them over there for another 3-week rental job. And then a lady's going to bring me some knives tomorrow morning. She's from the Eastern Shore. She's going to drop them off and wants me to sharpen them while she's shopping. She's going to pick them up in the afternoon. All right, stand by. I'll get back to you in a little while. It's a beautiful day in the 70s today. Man, I should be spinning. I don't know if I'll ever get to spin again. Oh, yeah, I will. She's moving along really good, running all over the house like a crazy person now. Stand by. Well, I picked up some knives. I got a 8-inch serrated knife that I needed to match up theirs. I got a fish fillet knife, 8-inch, lasting cut. And I bought a nicer grade knife. This is a Dexter serrated knife. They had two of theirs. They have two of these in there. What I'm going to pick up now, their own knives, you know. These are nice knives. They're about twice the price of this one. Made in China. Okay, headed home. Well, I picked up the restaurant knives. 11 of them. Mostly Dexters, but there are two Henkels in here. There's a Henkel. There's a Henkel. Then there's one, two, three lasting cuts. One, two, three, four, five Dexters. Nice knives. Better than a lot of restaurants I work with. Three serrated, four chefs, no, three chefs. I must have missed one because they got four in the picture they sent me. Oh, I got another serrated, so that's another one too. Good gracious. Okay, that's it. I got to pick my leader up. We're going somewhere. We're going shopping. Therapist just pulled up. Chris's therapist. Draw knives. God, have I ever used any of these when I was a kid. My father was a fisherman. And we set what they call pound nets in Chesapeake Bay. And we used these draw knives to skin the bark off the trees, straight pine trees or oak or fir or whatever we could get at the time, to put the net on the, so the chafe wouldn't chafe the net. We left the bark on the lower half of the pole that we either pumped or drove into the ocean, the bay I should say. And the top part was just no bark, plain wood. Sometimes we painted them in the summertime with copper paint to keep the what do you call them? Not termites, but the same thing in wood, in poles. Worms, they got a name, but I can't think of them right now. Anyway, I got these along with the restaurant knives I picked up. And it's a shade after 9. And I got a lady supposed to be bringing me some knives from the Eastern Shore to sharpen this morning. So we'll wait till she gets here. We'll try to do them all at the same time. These restaurant knives I picked up yesterday, I'm going to have to put the buffer on some of them. They got, you know how I am about scrapes and scratches. Not all of them, but look at that one. You see the scrapes and scratches along the edge, yeah? Some of them are worse than others. This was not too bad here. The little, the ankles are terrible. I presume they're just really old. This one's okay. All right, I'll get back to you. Looks like it's gonna be nice Tuesday. Started on the draw knives. Nothing major yet. Just getting the edge. This had some nicks and stuff in it I didn't see until I started working on it. And then the lady pulled up with the from the shore I was telling you about. She's got a Wusthof, two Cutcos, International, I don't know what that is. Oh, Gunzu, that's a nice ticket. Some International Henkel, a Wusthof, and this is a Wusthof with the tip broke off. And one pair of Fiskars. Okay. Like I said, Knife Tuesday. Ton of grit. It done. Now these restaurant knives I picked up yesterday, like I said, they're really in bad shape as far as scratches and stuff goes. Not all of them. Instead of using my sister wheel, I'm going to put this 3M clone wheel on and take the bulk of the scratches out with that, since it's faster.
Yes. Yes. Now which one would...
Restaurant knives. Done. We just gotta wash them off a little bit more. Then we're coming back to this baby. Tomato cutter. I tell you, that gray Scotch-Brite, well, it's not a Scotch-Brite, non-woven wheel is actually, I think, better than a sisal wheel at getting the scratches out. It don't really get good up here against the end because you can't get in there. But all in all, it's a whole lot faster. Remember how bad a shape this old Wusthof was? She's like almost like new. And this one turned out even better. This one's had a hard life. Let me get over here in the light a little bit. Look at the pits in it. Deep pits in the blade. She cleaned up nice, and she's really sharp. This big serrated knife, the wheel did a fantastic job on it. The other knives weren't too bad. This one was scratched up a little bit, but not too much. That fish fillet knife was okay. This one was fairly okay. And this one got a little treatment. Okay, that's the end of the restaurant knives. I'm just going to put them in their little box and they'll sit there for 20 more days. Well, this sharpening stone for the Dremel works good, only in the two outer ones. It's so, it won't fit in there. You see how tight it is? That little gray one, we'll try it next. Now we're going to end this nice video on this tomato cutter. Who the hell knew my life was going to be determined by tomatoes and how to cut them, so to speak. What I say this was, let's make sure. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 blades. This one, like I said, was broke off. The second one, you can see it's lower than the rest of them. This little file seems to do the best. I may have to buy another one to get them all done. The Dremel, everything was too wide, all of those round stones. And they roughed the edges up. I did this one. You can see it. I doubt you can see it, but it's there. Then I use this file. I think this is going to be the go-to file. Go to this first. Clean up the edges and get the nicks and chips out of them. Then use this little file. Both of these tapered. This is that CRT VEF job, VEF sharp, you know, that he makes the sharpener to sharpen his serrations with. It works pretty good on them, these taquitos right here. This is diamond pin. So I think we're going to go here, here, and these. I was hoping my ceramic rod, the corners of them, might fit in there. I haven't tried them yet today. I'll do that tomorrow. I'm getting tired of messing with this thing. But I'm going to stick it out there tonight and get some comments from you guys. See what you think about sharpening them. I mean, sharpening this thing. You can see, like I said, it's not very wide. This file is, you know how wide files are. It's tight in there. It's got a little bit of play. If we take this pointed diamond thing, it'll go down to about right there. Midway. I was thinking about folding a piece of sandpaper over and using it. That may work. I'll put it on a paint stick, but then it would be too thick. You need something thinner than a paint stick. You need something like this, but wider. Maybe a nice thin knife blade might work. I'm going to stick it out there and see what you think. That's the best way to sharpen this 14 blade tomato cutter. There's some pictures of the blade. See if you can see that, where I worked on it today. Now, once I did, okay, they're nice and sharp. They'll cut tomatoes fine. Those three right there. That's the ones when I really did both sides of it and finished up. So we're going to stick it out there anyway. So we're looking for comments. Tomato slicer. You can get the blades out. This thing is all made in one big fancy assembly. Pinned together. If you get the blades out and get them back in some kind of way, that would be the way to do it. But I'm not going there. End of story. Waiting for comments. Not from you, Hayhead. You're done for. Hayhead. Well, there it is. 14 blade tomato cutter. In a fancy aluminum housing. I bet this thing is expensive. The guy has to buy them. Can't sharpen them. He's got four of these. A brand new one he just put in the other day and three dull ones. They're tight between the gaps. I know you can see it, but I'll get it home. You might be able to get a better picture of it. Stand by. You see, this file just will fit in there. This braid here broke off from about there to there. The rest of them are okay. They're just dull. You can get the file in there. On the outside one's not too bad. The inside one, you see it's tighter. This one looks like they hit something with these three blades right here. These four blades right here got dings in them. I think I can rough them up with a file. I need to get my VEF diamond sharpener. I may be able to get my Dremel in there. Stand by. Columbia River diamond tool, serration sharpener. I was hoping this flat edge was thin enough to go in there, but it wasn't. Of course, the little tapered diamonds will go in there. This one and that one. I may end up using those. I've got a little teeny file I know will go in there. This diamond pencil thing I bought from Smith's. It's got a flat side on it too. I'm not sure. See, it won't go in there. It's too damn thick. I mean, it'll fit in there, but you have no movement. Might have to use the top of that. My goal, my hope was to use this DMT diamond file. It won't fit in that at all. It's way too big. It'll fit in the outside ones, but it won't fit in the inside ones at all. It's just too fat. Like my stomach. Bummer. Back to the drawing board. I think this little file is going to be the ticket. It will go in there and do a good job. You can get the good angle. And I'll show you what my secondary plan is.